Someday I'll wake and rub my eyes, and in that land beyond the skies, you'll find me.
Testing. Hello, and welcome to the 2019 presentation from Crossroads of The Wizard of Oz. We're so excited to have all of you here. I have two quick announcements, and then we're going to pray, and then we'll get into the show. The first is there's a brief intermission between the two acts, the two main acts. You're welcome to use the restroom. There's a water fountain right over here, and then on the other side of the church office. And then following the show, you're welcome to congratulate the cast, greet and meet with them. They might even sign autographs for you. And with that being said, we're again so thankful that you're all here. This is going to be the greatest show of all time, okay? And so I'm going to pray now, and then we'll get into it. Gracious Heavenly Father, we're so thankful for the art of story. We thank you that your attributes can be communicated to us through creativity, and we pray that you would bless us all this evening, help us to know you better in our lives, and be with the cast, calm any nerves they may have. We just pray that this would glorify you, and would this be a night to remember. We thank you again in Christ's name. Amen. And with that, I'll invite you to enjoy the show.
Uncle Henry, I'm home!
Oh, there you are. Goodness knows we've been lying where you were, young lady. Didn't you hear? There's a storm a-brewing.
I'm very sorry. I didn't mean to worry you. I was just reading outside in my treehouse with Toto.
Speaking of the storm, Dorothy, lock up the chicken coop before it starts to pour, will you?
We'd best prepare the house for the storm, dear. I've heard this storm's gonna be the worst one this town's had in years. I'll board up the windows and you bolt the cellar. We're gonna be in for a long one.
Soon. Uncle Henry will kill me for being out in this kind of weather.
Dorothy!
I'm coming, Uncle Henry! What is that? Oh no! I left Toto in the treehouse! Toto! I'm coming, Toto! I'm coming! Just hold on a second! Toto!
direction. Hashtag free the munchkins.
What? Can we see the body?
Ew!
You can't see the body. It's under the house. Duh.
Form a line, people. We need to greet our hero when they arrive.
Is the hero another good witch? Is the hero another good witch like Glinda?
The hero could be a fairy.
Or a mighty warrior.
Maybe the hero is like... Maybe the hero is like a... From Krypton, light years away, and he's set for here for his own protection. But little did he know the honest land who have great powers, fight, strength, and laser vision.
What are you rambling about?
I mean, I guess it could be that.
Well, let's go find that so-called hero.
Munchkins, please assemble. 4 score and 7 years ago.
I feel like I've heard this somewhere.
Preposterous. I've never in my life plagiarized. I have a dream.
That sounds awfully familiar, too.
One small step for the Munchkins and one.
Right,
today's a monumental, momentous, magnificent, marvelous, meritorious. As I was saying, this is a meritorious day for the Munchkins. Our chains have been broken. Our jail cells have flung open. The systematic oppression has ended. And because of this, we do what Munchkins do best. Absolutely nothing.
Toto? Where am I? Oh, Toto, we're not in Kansas anymore.
Welcome, most noble miss, to the land of the Munchkins. I'm the Mayor Munchkin.
Munchkins? What is this, Dunkin' Donuts?
Oh, ha, ha, ha. Dear, sweet Dorothy, so innocent, so pure. You were in Oz, dearie, the home of the Munchkin people and moi, the benevolent, kind, beautiful, dazzling, famous, and did I mention beautiful?
Witch, she's the Witch of the North.
That's Glinda the Good Witch, to you. I mean, what can I say? It's catchy.
Never mind her. We are entirely grateful for having you killed the Wicked Witch of the East. And from all of us here, we would like to say thank you. Guys, hello. Oh, there you are. No need to be shy. Hit it.
To stop the party here, but I didn't kill anyone. I couldn't even hurl a fly. I would never kill anyone. And I don't even know where I am. I was in Kansas 1 minute, and then bam, I ended up here. Can someone please tell me how to get home?
Oh, I must have forgotten to explain. You did kill the witch. She's right over, there, under your treehouse. You must have crushed her when you came flying in. How... very unfortunate.
I'm very sorry. I didn't mean to kill anyone.
Sorry? There's nothing to apologize for, Cupcake. Nothing at all. That witch captured all the Munchkins of Oz and kept them as their slaves. They are very grateful for you. Couldn't you tell?
But what about Kansas? Is it nearby?
What is this Kansas you speak of?
Is it a foreign country?
A sports car?
Yankee food, maybe.
No, it's my home, where I live with Aunt Em and Uncle Henry. It's where I was before the cyclone hit. I was just looking for my dog, Toto, when the wind picked me up and blew me into the sky. I must have hit my head pretty hard up in the treehouse. And now I'm here, in this strange land. You all seem very nice, but I would like to get home. I hope Aunt Em is not all worried about me.
Well, I don't know what an Aunt Em is, but I'm sure she's fine. But for now, you're with us, so let's make the best of it, shall we? I mean, I'm a witch, for goodness sake. I'll figure something out, Cupcake.
Witch? You're a witch? I thought all witches were evil. Plus, you don't look like the witches people dress up for Halloween, that's for sure. Are you really a witch?
Yes, indeed, and proud to be one. I am one of the only 4 witches in Oz. Well, that's... 3 now, isn't it? Anyways, there's the witch. witch of the north, the best in my unbiased opinion. The witch of the south, the one you killed. And of course, the wicked witch of the west.
Yeah!
We don't have any witches in Kansas.
No witches? Why, who is there to control all the magic?
Who is there to ride your brooms?
Or wear pointy hats?
Or to be dried at burn simply for the crime of being a woman in an area where women were not allowed to have a voice?
What?
Well, the only magic we have in Kansas is magicians at kids' birthday parties, if that counts as anything.
Oh, I see. You must come from a civilized land. Well, Oz is not yet civilized. We have been cut off from the rest of the world. We still have munchkins, witches, sorcerers, the great mighty Oz. Oh yes, maybe he can help you with this dilemma you're being faced with. Where'd you say you were from again? Can something? Yes, Kansas, that's it.
Glinda, the witch is gone.
The sun must have dried her right up. All that remains are her ruby red slippers. Oh well.
These are the prettiest shoes I've ever seen.
Take them, Cupcake. I don't want some dead person's shoes anyway. Well, I've got a busy schedule to attend to, so ta-ta now. Best of luck.
Oh, Glinda, your mani-pedi's at 250. Do you want me to push that back?
Yeah, real busy. Wait, tell me where the great wizard is. If you can help me, maybe he can.
You think I, Glinda the Good, don't have enough power to help you? You mere mortal, do you think you know anything about magic? You're right. I don't have the spell for this kind of stuff. But I can tell you where the wizard is.
You go, Glinda.
You're the best, Glinda.
It's true. I mean, the directions are simple, really. All you have to do is download Google Maps, type in Emerald City Suite. You know what? Just follow the Yellow Brick Road. It's simpler.
Bye, Dorothy. Best of luck now. Thank you for letting me keep this.
Now, Dorothy, this journey is not going to be easy. And those shoes you're wearing, or holding, they might have a teensy bit of magic in them. But
wait,
goodbye now.
Wait, Glinda, best of luck. Tell me about the shoes! Glinda!
Shock on crows' faces when I scare them makes it all worth it. Shoo, you filthy birds! Ugh, these darn crows. Let's see. Scary things. Global warming. Romaine lettuce! Wait, I got it. Jake Paul! Oh, nothing scares these crows anymore.
Don't eat that! Put that down! Ugh, where are you scared of me?
You're made of straw.
There's no point in trying anymore. Only one day I could just get down from here and... Hey, over here!
Hello? Is anyone there? I have magical shoes and I'm not afraid to use them! if I knew how that is.
Over here, the scarecrow, big tall smiling guy right over here.
You can talk?
Certainly can. How do you do, miss?
I'm doing fine, thank you. You're the politest scarecrow I ever met. Well, the only one, that is. How are you?
Well, I'm glad you asked. It's tedious being perched up here all day long and trying to scare crows who cannot be scared.
Can't you leave?
Can't. I have this pole holding me up. Maybe you could help me down. I would be forever grateful.
Maybe if I pull this up and take this out and...
Whoa!
Are you okay?
Yeah. I'm better. It's a miracle. I can walk again. But now where do I go?
I suppose you can come with me if you would like.
Wow, what a splendid idea. And what did you say your name was again?
Dorothy. I'm not from around here. I'm from a land called Kansas, far, far away.
Well, then what brings you around these parts, eh?
I'm trying to get home. I got here today, and I'm looking for the great wizard in the Emerald City.
The wizard? I've never heard of any wizard.
You never heard of the wizard? I thought everyone in Huss did.
Well, I am made out of straw and stuffing. I don't have any brains.
Maybe you can ask the wizard for some brains.
Wow, what a splendid idea. I'll come along with you. Whoa. Steady now. These legs don't work as well as they used to. Whoa!
Scarecrow's first steps. So cute.
Glinda, what are you doing here? I thought you were busy.
Mani-pedis can wait. I mean, it's not that often a human girl descends from the sky, after all. I'm just keeping an eye on you. That's all. And, well, this is fabulous content for the vlog.
Ah!
Oh, this is perfect for my epic fail compilation. I must go post this.
Are you okay? Here, let me help you.
Yeah. Don't you worry about me. I'm just a little wobbly, that's all. Bye-bye, crows. Wish me luck. And give my best to the farmers, will you? And I'm off to the Emerald City.
Scarecrow, the Emerald City is this way.
Right you are. I knew that. Totally knew that. I'm gonna love having brains.
Scarecrow, maybe we could both use some rest.
Maybe you're right. Oh, we could take a nap under that tree over there. Dorothy, did you hear that? Okay, Scarecrow, calm down. Probably just the wind. Just sit back, relax, close your eyes.
What in all Kansas is making that noise? Oh, hello there.
Help me.
I think she needs our help. Dorothy.
She's all rusted.
Oil.
Ha ha, yeah, oil. I like oil too, buddy.
Oh, she needs her oil can.
Wow, what a great idea. Brains are amazing. But where is it?
Oh, here it is.
Oh, thank you so much. Now, would you mind getting my head, shoulders, knees, and toes?
Of course.
Thank you so much. I was scared that I'd be stuck here forever. No one's passed by this path in years. What made you both pass by?
Well, we're on our way to the wizard in the Emerald City. Dorothy here needs a way to get back home to Kansas, and I'm hoping that the wizard could lend me some money? Clothes? Wait, no. I have those. Oh, brains! I need brains.
Do you think I could come along with you guys? I'm in desperate need for a heart.
Of course. It should be as easy as getting me home and getting Scarecrow some brains.
So, Tin Man, how'd you get to Rust in the first place?
Well, Scarecrow, it was all because of love.
Love?
I fell in love with a handsome Munchkin boy. He was the boy of my dreams, but his mother didn't like me very much because I was made of tin. She thought her son deserved better.
Oh no, Tin Man, then what happened?
Well, the day before our wedding, his mother hired the Wicked Witch of the West to come sabotage our wedding. Her flying monkey stole my heart right out of my chest. And then I was left in a rainstorm and all I could do was rust.
That's horrible, Tin Man. What happened to the Munchkin girl?
I don't have a clue. Maybe he's still waiting for me.
Scarecrow? Are you crying?
Nope. I think it's just allergies. I'm allergic to hay.
Hay? Aren't you made of hay?
Excuse me. I'm made of organic, gluten-free, free-range, fair trade, non-GMO straw. Thank you very much.
Well, Tin Man, thank you for telling us that story. Well, let's get a move on and get the heart fast.
To the Emerald City.
Hey, beautiful, darling, loving fans. Welcome back to the vlog. If you've been keeping up with my latest videos, you know that I am following the adorable adventure of my dearest, darling, Dorothy from Kansas. Oh, what a sweet, innocent, murderous angel. Let's see what she's up to now.
I wish I had time to stop and cut down all these terrible trees.
I'm not sure about that. These trees doesn't look like the trees back home.
Maybe we're going the wrong way. We should turn back.
We're following the Yellow Brick Road. We can't turn back now.
Ah!
Why didn't you just go around that?
I didn't even think to. You see, this is why I need a brain.
Roar!
Shh! Did you hear that?
Hear what?
Roar!
It sounds like a
lion!
Stop! Don't hurt us!
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. I thought you guys were monsters. Oh, I'm a failure. My mom was right. I am a coward.
What makes you a coward?
I'm supposed to be the king of the beasts and roar powerfully, but instead, I roar to protect myself. When I heard you guys coming, I thought you might be after me.
Why would we be coming after you?
I don't know, I'm a coward. I thought I could scare you guys away before you scared me. Whenever there's danger around, my heart beats so fast I can hardly stand it.
Well, that sounds more like a heart disease.
Well, great, now I'm a coward and I have heart disease.
Well, you should consider yourself lucky, because it proves you have a heart. I don't have the luxury of having a heart, so I can't have a heart disease.
Maybe if I didn't have a heart, I would have courage.
Well, do you have a brain?
I think so. It's not hollow in there.
Well, I'm going to the Great Oz to ask for some brains, since my head is just filled with straw.
And I'm going to ask for a heart, so I could care for my love again.
And we want to go back home to Kansas.
Do you think he could give me courage?
I don't know. You'll have to ask. But you could come along with us and scare away other scary beasts.
Sure, I guess.
Well, we better get going soon. It's gonna get dark.
What was that?
What?
I don't know. I guess I'm hearing things. Here we go. Wow, guys, this isn't so bad after all.
Buddy? Hate to break it to you, but we kind of haven't moved yet.
Oh, right. This way. What was that?
I guess I'll lead the way. Finally! Look, guys! We're out of the woods!
I'm so glad to be out of those cursed woods after 12 long years. I could just cry.
Don't! You'll rust!
And lose your dignity.
You're right. I had to keep it together for my love.
The yellow brick road, lead us through these flowers! It's too good to be true!
When I have a brain, I'm sure I'll appreciate them much more.
And when I have a heart, I bet I'll be able to love these flowers very much.
Flowers! Flowers bring bees! Bees sting! Stings lead to infections! Infections lead to hospitals! And hospitals lead to... death!
Hey, guys, it's okay, really. After all the dangerous paths this yellow brick road led us to, a field of flowers is nothing to worry about. Nothing. Nothing at all.
I don't know, guys. I've seen the Wicked Witch do some terrible things, and I wouldn't put it past her to put a spell on these flowers. Dorothy? Scarecrow?
Psh! Magic spell? They're just some pretty flowers.
Guys? Come on, Dorothy? Oh, no. They won't budge. Come on, guys. We're almost there. There's no point. Well... oh, well, I guess a nap wouldn't hurt right now.
Short witch me for? I will have my revenge on you, Dorothy. You killed my sister, and I won't let you take over my kingdom. No, not on my watch. Now you have a nice little nap, dearie. You'll be needing it once I get my hands on you. This isn't the last of you'll see of me.
I was so scared.
Wait, where's Toto?
Oh, no, I left Toto.
In the treehouse.
Oh, wait, really?
In the treehouse.
You know, I'm leaving my red ruby shoes there. Thank you. Wait, I thought Toto was here.
Oh, I put it back there.
Oh, thank you.
Is the mic still on? I think the mic is still on. I think the mic's still on. I think the mic's still on. I feel like the mic is still on. Okay. Oh, it's right here. It's right here. Someone brought it back. Well, let's go. The cookies! Cookies! Oh, I gotta drop these.
Wow, I can't believe we're finally here.
Yeah, it sure took us long enough.
If I had the brains, I could have known those flowers were dangerous.
Well, at least we're here, right? Yeah, we were delayed, but we're here, and that's all that matters. Well, time to go home.
Just wait 1 minute. Like the new look?
That was beautiful. It's awesome. It's
amazing. Oh, thank you. Thank you. I mean, I just woke up like this. Wow. You know, I'm really surprised you made it this far. You know how I told you I believed in you? I really didn't.
Wow. Thanks, Glinda.
What? You exceeded my expectations. That's a good thing. Now, this is the hardest part of your journey, so be careful.
Do you know the wizard?
Yes, well, he's my ex. And he is not a man to be tampered with. He left me for that witch, Jessica.
But aren't you a witch?
And aren't you made of tin? We all have our issues.
Glinda, will you come with us?
You're being serious. No. I try not to deliberately put myself in dangerous and, like, deadly situations.
Deadly?
Yeah, I mean, my face is far too pretty and my nails far too fragile to get messed up in messy magical situations like this one. Well, to Tano, best of luck.
Wait, but...
Well, I guess it's just us again.
Well, Lion, why don't you go knock?
No, maybe you should, since you're tin and bulletproof.
I'll do it. Hello, I'm here to see the Great Wizard of Oz.
Yes, the wizard said, right?
Yes, the Great Wizard of Oz. He's going to help us.
Sorry, ma'am. My manager doesn't tell me what to do, so I'm asked for a wizard. It's my first day in the job, and, well, I just get the manager.
Don't people come here often to see the wizard?
Well, yes, no. Well, I don't know. I'll be back.
Hello. I would recommend you turn around right now.
What? No, why?
I am the guardian of the gate. It has been many years since anyone has asked to see the wizard. It is great and terrible. If you come on foolish errand to bother the Great Oz, he will surely destroy you and all you love. He will crush you in an instant.
But we do not come with foolish requests. We have been told he is a powerful wizard who can grant us what our hearts desire.
A wise ruler, yes. Powerful, but not kind to his subjects. Few have ever tried to seek his face, and none have ever come out alive. And you four, you have no chance.
But we have to see him.
Very well, you'll seal your fate, young ones. I'll put in an order for your gravestones now. Would you prefer marble or granite?
Ooh, marble, please.
Wait.
Welcome to the Emerald City.
Whoa.
It's amazing.
Wow.
Marvelous.
It's super magnifico stupendo fantabulous.
What? You can't blame me. I don't have a brain, duh.
Come now. Now, stop! I'll be right back to get the wizard. He has surely been made aware of your journey long before you arrived.
Then why didn't he help us earlier?
Shush! Don't ask such foolish questions. If you keep that up, he'll strike you down before you can even say Oz.
Oz!
Sorry, I thought we were all saying it together.
They don't stand a chance. I'll be back shortly.
That was rude. Yeah, I'm scared.
Hey, losers.
Hey, nerds.
Yes, you? Is it true you're going to see the wizard?
Yes. Do you know anything about him?
He's everything and nothing. All at once.
Wait, huh? You guys don't get that either, right?
You poor ignorant fools. You make Oz angry for your foolish remarks.
You hear that? He mad.
Well, I heard that just last month, a group came in to see the wizard. You know what happened to him?
No.
They were made into these.
You.
Well, even if you don't get made into his dolls, I hear he appears as a ball of fire ready to hurl his flames at anyone who disturbs them.
And I'm like, submit!
or he appears as a giant spider ready to trap anyone who enters his lair and his web and eat them alive.
Ew, gross, man. And I heard Bake's the best cherry pie in all of Oz.
Quit ruining everything.
How do you know all this if you've never seen him before?
Rumors, suspicions.
Honestly, guys, I think he's making this up.
Well, there's no reason to panic. No reason at all. Just remember what you want and how much you want it.
We will. Just leave us alone.
Well, good luck now. Don't get scared.
Oh, if I were you guys, I would be like so scared right now.
We'll see you now.
When you guys have
friends. I hear you're all powerful.
That I am, Dorothy. Thank you. You're really too kind.
Now what do you want?
I want to go back home to Kansas to be with Aunt Em and Uncle Henry. I love our country, but I do miss home. You see, I came here in a storm and then I got these shoes and they're supposed to be magic and I was sent to...
Where did you get those shoes?
I got it These are the Wicked Witch's shoes, but Glinda the Good Witch gave them to me.
Okay. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Why should I help you?
I suppose you should help me because you're powerful and I'm not. You're the only person who could get me home.
But you were powerful enough to kill a witch. You can get home just fine on your own.
No. I can't. That was an accident. No, if you would just...
Enough! Next!
Howdy, sir, ma'am, wizard thingy.
Howdy to you too.
Now who are you?
I'm only but a mere scarecrow, made with some strong cotton, not of much use to anyone.
So why should I help you?
Well, I would like to become an intellectual like others in your kingdom, not guard the cornfields from an Oz from crows all day.
Okay, yes.
Now who are you, man in silver?
I think he may have wet himself in fear. You see, he rusts very easily, and I don't know if he can move very well. There we go.
I'm the Tin Man.
Yes.
Well, I just want a heart, plain and simple. I hope you grant my wish so I could be like the others in Oz, and so I could care for my love again.
So why should
I give you a heart?
Well, because I asked, and because you alone could grant it.
Okay, yep, thank you.
Next! You lion! What is it you want from me?
I'm a cowardly lion, afraid of everything. My wish is to be granted courage so I may truly become the king of the beasts.
So why should I give you the courage you beg for?
Because you're the only one who can give it, and you know what? My friends and I deserve what we ask for. We are noble, and we were so bold as to come find you. We have traveled far and wide looking for you. We have faced horrible creatures, scary woods, long nights, weary days, and poisonous flowers to be here. That is why you should give us what we ask for. Thank you for coming to my TED Talk.
Yeah, you're funny. You do not deserve anything from me! That is until you've done something to repay me! I see that you're all very desperate for my magic, and I will use it. But at a cost! Everyone in this kingdom works for what they earn, and you're now working for me! Help me, and I will help you. Got it?
What do you require of us?
Just a simple task. It's not that big of a deal, isn't it? Kill the Wicked Witch of the West!
What? How are we supposed to do that?
If you ever wish to see your poor little uncle and auntie again, oh boo-hoo, so sad, you must do as I say! She resides in the land west of the Emerald City. And now go. Kill her if you ever want what you've asked of me. I wish to never see any of you again, dead or alive, until you've done what I asked for. I said go!
Would you look at that? It seems that the saddest creatures in Oz have become best buds. Oh, how cute. Much better. Much better.
Oh, they're so cute.
Quiet! Go get me my hat!
Yes, Mr. Hulk.
Right away. Oh.
Yes, Mr. Hulk. It's right away.
Hulk! Oh, those foolish monkeys. Now let's see here. A scared little lion. A brainless scarecrow.
Your hat, Bruce Banner.
Let's see. Now let's see. A brainless scarecrow, a heartless tin man, move! and let's see, and a pretty little girl with her pretty little shoes. Well, they won't be hers for long. Flying monkeys full of trouble, come to me on the double!
Here we come.
Silence! Now, my evil servants, look here! I want you to get the pretty girl in the ruby shoes and her little friends. And I want you to bring them to me immediately! Go!
Is this the witch's lair?
Shh! What?
Talk a little louder, huh? Okay!
No!
You told me to!
Unless you happen to have a box of thin mints to sell, you do not walk into an evil witch's lair like that.
We need to have a plan. I don't have any houses to drop this time.
Maybe we could throw garlic at her.
That only works on vampires.
Oh, we could destroy her brains.
That only works on zombies.
Oh, we can build a rat trap.
That obviously only works on rats.
Why would
I'm sorry, Dad. Guys! Where's the scarecrow? I'll go look over here.
I'll look over. Oh no! Now where's Tin Man? Oh no! Oh no!
It's okay. We'll find them. Just take a deep breath. I'll go look over here again. I couldn't find the lion. Lion!
I'm afraid it's just me, darling. You come in. Let's make this quick because I have to be in bed by 6:30.
You're the witch? I thought you would be more, how do you say this, intimidating.
Is that better?
I guess. What have you done with my friends?
I think the more pertinent question here is, what have you done with my sister?
Your sister?
My sister? Tall, black hair, wore ruby red slippers, got crushed by your house!
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to.
You didn't mean to commit murder?
Honestly, I just...
And he's the nerve, the audacity to come in here wearing my dead sister's shoes. Can't you see I'm the victim here? If only someone would tell my side of the story. Perhaps the award-winning Broadway musical.
I won't ask again. Where are my friends?
I'd be more concerned about your own well-being now. My pet, you are gonna pay for what you did. Bubble, bubble, toil and trouble. Let this breath. Turn into rubble. You think you're pretty clever, aren't you? But you never feel Hershey's because you'll be far, far too small. Bubble and pop, gurgle and click. Let this potion make her shrink. Yeah! No! I'm shrinking! Shrinking! You'll pay for the store that you pay!
Dorothy! Dorothy, are you all right? Where's the witch? Look at her!
Dorothy, are you all right?
Are you all right? What happened?
You're okay! You're all safe!
Where's the witch?
I think it's safe to say she won't bothering anyone anymore. Come on, let's go see the wizard. Yes, sir. The Wicked Witch has been, cut down to size.
I must say, I'm, impressed. More importantly on the fact that you're alive.
Now, you have to keep your promise.
Yeah, I will, but, maybe not today.
What?
You heard me! I'll get to your brains and hearts and whatever nonsense you have in my own due time. Thank you very much.
That was not our agreement. We did what you asked for. Now give us what you promised.
You dare make demands of the great and powerful laws? I should crush you to smithereens! I should tear you limb by limb! I don't know what other excuses to give you.
He's not a wizard!
Yeah, I should have fixed that curtain, shouldn't I?
Why, you're just a man!
Ta-da!
You're not great or powerful, but you are kind of short.
Listen to me, young man. I'm average size.
Why, you're just a... Are you a wizard?
Well, some say I'm a wizard in the kitchen. I could whip up a nice creme brulee, if you know what I'm saying.
Do you do magic?
Isn't the real magic found in friendship, love, community? Isn't that what truly
can
bring people...
Can you do real, actual magic?
No.
But you promised me a brain!
A heart.
Courage.
Home!
Well, let's see. Don't fret yet. Scarecrow, you wanted a brain, yes? Well, where I come from, there's a place called college where people will spend hours upon hours working for a piece of paper that can prove to the world that they're somehow smarter than you will ever be. I present to you something that, in my economy, is way more important than a brain. A diploma! Neat, isn't it?
I feel so different. 16 cubed is 4,096. Mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell. And did you know that the green light in The Great Gatsby actually represents all of Gatsby's idealistic dreams for the future?
Cram it, nerd. We get it. You're a genius. And you, Tin Man, you wanted a heart.
Yes.
Don't you know how terrible it is to have a heart? I think you should listen to any Adele song.
Any what song?
Never mind.
I just want a heart so I could care for my munchkin boy again.
Answer me this. Have you ever once stopped thinking of your munchkin boy?
No, he's always in my thoughts.
Would you sacrifice for his happiness?
Yes, of course.
Would you do anything to be with him?
Yes.
My silly girl, you're already in love. You don't need a heart to tell you that. But just so everyone else can see, here's a gift just for you. And you, Lion, I have a quote just for you that I am sure will be just for you. Get this. All right, get ready to hear this one. Courage is not the absence of fear, but rather the knowledge that something else is more important than fear.
That sounds really familiar.
No. Yep. It was all my original idea, yep. You already possess courage, Lion. You stood for your friends, you bred a terrifying journey, and you fought a witch! Kind of! What you need to show the world your courage is just one big fat medal!
Wow, a medal!
But what about Dorothy?
Can you get me home?
Yeah, how do I put this? While I'm perfectly capable of presenting these semi-meaningless things to your friends that can make them feel fulfilled, somehow, I'm not capable of teleportation. I'm sorry, dear.
Oh, no.
You can stay with us, Dorothy.
Yeah, we'll be your home.
We all love you, Dorothy. I love you, Hope, but I miss my real home, too. I just need to go back.
You have to go back, you say.
Glinda the Good Witch, you're here. Please, please send me home.
I already told you, I don't have the magic for that kind of stuff, but you do.
What do you mean?
You've always had the magic to go back to Kansas, but there were things you needed to accomplish here first, and I wanted to show my vlog.
So, how do I get back home to Kansas?
Well, the directions are simple, really. The shoes you're wearing, I told you, they have a little bit of magic in them. All you have to do is click your heels 3 times and say there's no place like home.
Thank you.
Go on, Cupcake. Click, click, click.
Wait.
Goodbye, Dorothy.
Goodbye, Lion.
I hope one day to be as courageous as you are.
Oh, Dorothy, you're the one who made me so courageous.
Goodbye. Goodbye, Tin Man. You had the biggest heart of anyone I ever known. Oh, don't cry, you're Russ.
I'd rest for you any day, Dorothy.
Well, I guess I'll see you around, Dorothy.
I don't care if you had a brain or not. You knew what was important, that I needed a friend, and you were the best friend I ever had.
And you were mine?
Well, I guess it's time to go. There's no place like home. There's no place like home. There's no place like home.
Dorothy, please wake up!
What happened? Aunt Em! Uncle Henry! I'm so glad to be home! You won't believe what happened!
Oh, we know what happened, dear. You just got caught out in the storm trying to save Toto and you must have hit your head in your treehouse.
No, that's not what happened. The wind just picked me up and blew me into the sky. Oz. Glinda, the red ruby shoes. Oh, I hope my friends are okay.
Oh dear, you must be very confused right now. You hit your head hard on the ceiling of your treehouse. Good thing I went after you and got you into bed. And don't worry, Toto is safe with us.
No, I'm not confused. I was just in a land called Oz, and I used the magical shoes, and that got me home.
Well, wherever you were in your dream, you're home now. I'm gonna call the doctor. This is a worse concussion than I feared. She's delusional.
Well, don't worry, Dorothy. We'll be back with the doctor. The storm has calmed. We'll be back, Dorothy. Hold on tight. Bye-bye, dear.
No, it wasn't a dream. It couldn't have been. It was all so real. And magical. I knew it.
Pastor Johnny? Where is he? Somewhere out there, right? There he is. All right, come on up, Johnny. All right, here we go.
I don't think I have a mic. Oh, here we go. I have a mic. Hey, wasn't that the best show of all time? We have one small gift for the directors on behalf of our only graduating eighth grade student who participated in the play, Elizabeth Vanderplot. I believe the flowers are coming.
Is your mic on? Is your mic on?
I don't think so.
Here, we'll use this one. Here, would you like to say something to the directors?
I would just like to thank the directors for putting this on every year. It's always a great show, and it's always just a great experience to be involved in, and without them, I probably wouldn't be the person I am right now. So I would just like to really thank them because they are amazing, and they really did a great job putting the show together.
We have been tremendously blessed with the drama leadership that we've been fortunate to have here at Covenant for Crossroads, and we're just so thankful for them and the quality of work that they get to do in 4 weeks, and then the viewership is outstanding, so thank you all for being here. We have a quick announcement about this upcoming Sunday. So we want to integrate the Crossroads experience for adults too, for anyone who wants to participate in that, see what it's like for the kids, and really take part in some of the stuff that we do every single day at camp. We'll sing some songs, do some dance moves, we'll do a verse of the day, and we'll really just celebrate what it is like for the kids to come to Crossroads every day of the summer. We'd love to invite you to come to that at 10 a.m. this upcoming Sunday for Crossroads Sunday. So, Pastor Jim,
a couple last things, too. We just want to throw in there. This Sunday is going to be really an awesome opportunity. We appreciate you sending your kids to our camp. It's been a blast to have them just running through the hallways. There's just so much excitement, so much life. They're really good kids, and they put on a great show. And so this is just one last invite. We'd love to have you come Sunday at 10 o'clock for the service. Like Pastor Johnny said, we're returning to Crossroads service. It's going to be really fun. I know some parents are probably thinking, I haven't heard fun in church next to each other in a long time. But if you come Sunday, I promise, just like he said, Crossroads campers, you know the deal. It's a lot of fun. So we're going to bring that into the service. We're going to take one scene from the play. It's going to be an awesome opportunity to bless everyone who's here. If you have parents of little children, we will have childcare from ages 5 down. So there will be things there for the kids as well, if you're worried about that. And services go from 10 to 11. They're 1 hour, 5 minutes. If we go over, that's about it. So you can get back on your way. And if you're not in a rush, we have free coffee and bagels every Sunday after church. So we'd love to have you. Let me close in prayer. I know you need to get home. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much that we were blessed with this time of fellowship and by the just sheer talent of such young people who have such promise for the future. We want to bless them. We ask that you would bless them and that they would just do wonderful things in this world. And we thank you that we've had such a great time at camp. You've kept everybody safe. We pray that the next session goes just as smooth. And we pray a blessing also on the directors and those who helped run this. Lord, so much work went into this, and it really came off phenomenally. Thank you for Pastor Johnny and the work he puts into the camp, Lord. It's really been a blessing to our church and to this community. We ask for your continued favor. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. All right, you have a great night. God bless.
If you guys want to head over to the gym, there's refreshments there, and your kids will join you there in a little bit. Thanks.